your boy King Brando, and today I'm coming at you with another reaction video. In this, well, review video of Grownish Episode 8, Erase Your Social or Erase Your Social Media, whatever it's called. I think it's called that. I don't know. Let me check real quick. Yeah, Erase Your Social. Sorry. And this episode was filled with, like, a lot of lessons, but the main one, the moral of the story, social media, it can be like used to progress, and it can be used to regress, digress, whatever, whichever one means to like go backward and not grow. It was a lot of stuff that happened in this episode. Zoe had a fellowship that she got. Remember, she got the rec from Dean Parker. She got the fellowship. Luca got the fellowship too. Guess what? Luca's back. Yeah, he's back. He's back. And he's still Luca. Still Luca. Mysterious. Is just like something about him. It's just like, man, I want to be friends with that guy. I want to be friends with that guy. And yeah, Zoe got a fellowship. She screwed it up because of social media. She should have just kept going Zero Dark 30. A lot else happened. Nomi and Anna took on Janelle Monae. They lost. Aaron, you need to do a little bit more reading if you're going to be like a social activist or something like that. Because you messed up. And the twins, y'all are ruthless. Y'all are ruthless. Like, y'all are ruthless, for real. They clowned Vivek because Vivek tried to clown them too. He tried to make a point, but they got you. When you do that, you got to make sure like you are just clear of everything. Clear of everything. But let's get into this review video.
Yeah.
Take me to the truth.
Before we start the video, let's talk about Valentine's Day. This is the worst man-made holiday ever. Like, it's just terrible. Like, I don't get it. Like, fill me in the comment section. Like, do y'all celebrate Valentine's Day? Do y'all do this whole thing where you just go all out for somebody on this one day, and like the other 364 days you just do nothing, really? Like, this is really an excuse to like say that you've done something, which you really should be doing stuff like periodically through the year. You're supposed to like, you know, do stuff for your other, you know, significant other. Like, you're supposed to do that throughout the year. People shouldn't have to make a holiday for you to do that. But, and yeah, it's just like full of a bunch of just BS. For real. I'm sorry, y'all. But it just is. Like, I don't believe in it. I don't celebrate it. Even if I had a girl, still wouldn't celebrate it. Because it's just like, you know, I'm one of those people where, you know, if it's a holiday where you have to do this, I will wait a week after or give you stuff a week before just to like be like, you know, we don't need this holiday to, you know, make you feel good. I don't need to like have the pressure of that. I'm gonna make you feel good all year round like that. And yeah, and this notion of like, you know, you gotta have a Valentine's Day, or like you like sad or something like that, you probably ain't sad, you know. You just, sorry, I felt myself going off in a tangent there about Valentine's Day. But if you celebrate it, you celebrate it. Do you? You know, I just think, you know, we should focus on each other all year. All year. And, like, really, I didn't even know it was a thing called Sweetest Day. Like, I didn't even know that. Like, Valentine's Day is supposed to be for girls, and Sweetest Day is supposed to be for the guys. I didn't even know that. Like, for real. I didn't. That's how little value y'all place on us. But we gotta go all out for y'all. That's bogus. But let's get back to the Grownish review. So, I'm just gonna hit the main points because I don't want to make a long video today. I'm kind of rushed on some time. I'm sorry, y'all. Y'all know it's all love. Next week, we're gonna be back to, you know, well, it's gonna be, they taking like a little 2-week break. But when it come back, we're gonna be hitting it with like the 15-minute videos because I know that's what y'all like. And yeah, basically in Grownish, this episode, Zoe got her fellowship, the one that she always wanted because, you know, she's a fashionista. She wants to do fashion. And Luca, he like just literally walked his way into a internship or fellowship or whatever. And Zoe got chosen to be the beautiful Elaine Welter's assistant for like to like be trained by her or whatever and like shadow her. And that was dope for her until, you know, she messed up. But before I get to that, Elaine told her, don't embarrass me. Somebody else told me that when I was in your position. Don't embarrass me. I can do that on my own. Didn't work out too well. So Zoe, she got off social media after she done got verified and all that, and she thinks she clouded up, thinks she got all the popularity. She went off social media, did a LeBron, tried to chill while everybody else, while Nomi was battling Janelle Monae, she was going in on her own. God, she was going in on her. Then she taught Anna how to troll, which was hilarious. Like, I'm like, golly, this is the bad part of social media that they was talking about. The trolling. And then we gonna get into Aaron's part. Aaron, you just didn't read a lot. Really didn't. He was on social media and there was like, Zoe, since she was off of it, she was like, you know, we should all have fun together, you know, do stuff. But Nomi and Anna trolling, like I just said, and Aaron, he was trying to be a political activist and just like, you know, fight for equality and all that, but he didn't read the fine print. Like, he just read the big stuff. You know how they say in contracts when they get screwed, you didn't read the fine print? He didn't read the fine print. He didn't read the whole thing before retweeting it, before posting the links. He posted some bad stuff. It was just like really bad. It was like, you know, I forgot what it was, but it was like something to like, it was pretty bad, pretty bad. And Vivek, he basically was like, you know, he was trolling the twins too until they got back at him. He found their, what's it called? I forgot what they used as it, but it's like, you know, you make a private Twitter for your friends and all that. The stuff that you don't want everybody else to see. Well, you know, you show your party and your goofy side, the side that, you know, it's not really for everybody. You know, but I get that too. But he found theirs and, you know, exposed until they found him getting knocked out by a biker. You scratched a dude bike. He saw you. He just jawed you. World star. World star. And yeah, and the twins came in with the best comic relief like ever. They are just, they're brilliant. Luca, you're back, man. You're back. He back. And then him and Aaron had this little one thing, which I was like, man, y'all could have did some old stuff, but we found out in this episode that Zoe still likes Luca, so maybe that triangle is still there, even though he kind of like disappeared for like 4 or 5 years. I don't know where he went. We don't know either. But yeah, basically the episode, like to sum it all up, the rest of the stuff that happened, Zoe lost her she didn't lose her fellowship. She lost the, you know, the shadowing job to Luca because she posted a picture and it kind of outed their whole collection that they were going to be doing like a piece to or whatever. So Elaine was pissed off. She was like, you know, I told you don't embarrass me. You had one job, Zoe. You had one job and you effed up. So Luca took a place and he's like, you know, I do good work too. I do good work too. And yeah, and Anna and Nomi got blocked off of Twitter. Actually, they got suspended and Nomi, she got like outed completely off Twitter. And Aaron, he finally figured out that he was like not reading the fine print, and it ended with like somebody who he really hates like following him, and he's like, you know, the worst person in the world. Well, I mean, Trump, the worst person in the world, but the worst person in the world is following me. Like, this is not supposed to be happening. I'm supposed to be fighting against them, and he's following me. I did a bad thing. But yeah, it ends off with everybody just like, you know, disconnecting from social media and just having fun until they hear a song that they like. And everybody's like, you know, what's this song called? I can't think of it. Then Luke will come in for the save at the end. It's this song. We never got to know what the song was. But yeah, that was episode 8 of Grownish in like 5 minutes. Yeah, it was like 5 minutes, right? It was a dope episode. I liked it. It wasn't one of my favorites. It was just like, it was a mid-season episode to me. Nothing important really happened like that. And yeah, but I did like I liked the episode though. It had a lot of spots where, you know, it's always something relevant to Blackish and Grownish. Like, this is about social media and how it can help us. Like, it helped Zoe because, you know, she got the internship and she kind of fitted the role of somebody who would have it like a fashionista. She got a clout up and all that. She went Zero Dark 30. Then it kind of showed the bad. Oh yeah, and Aaron trying to do like good, but then it showed the bad with Aaron like not reading the fine print and Zoe just like, you know, accidentally posting something that she shouldn't have posted. And I'm like, you know, I kind of get it. I get it. And yeah, that was episode 8 of Grownish. Make sure y'all subscribe to the channel. please subscribe to the channel. Join the Brando fam. That is what we are called. We are almost at 1,000 subscribers. We like 8 away right now. We're 8 away from 1,000 subscribers. Never dreamed this would happen. I'm so grateful, y'all. I love y'all. If you return to the channel, like the video. Tell me your thoughts on this episode and what you think is going to come in the last 5 episodes of this season. Tell me what you think is going to happen, y'all. And if you're new to the channel, still tell me what you think is going to happen. Like the video. But you gotta do the 3 clicks. I told you one of them. You just like the video. Then you subscribe to the channel. Then you hit them post notifications. Like, please do that so you can join the Brando fam. We are lit. I'm sorry I'm talking real fast. But yeah, we're lit. We are almost there at 1,000 subscribers. Never dreamt this would happen. So proud of y'all. I'm proud of y'all. Because, like, I'm not proud of me. Because, like, I do the stuff. But it's up to y'all to like it and tell me like what stuff I should work on. So I'm grateful for y'all. I'm grateful. Love y'all. It's been your boy King Brando. Peace.
Yeah.
Take me to the truth.